Hello everybody, boys and girls, Dr. Carlo Oger, emergency physician for edexitvideo.com. First, I want to thank this patient and his family for allowing me to record this video. This is a procedure that's not often done in the emergency department. I'm going to go ahead and describe what I'm doing now, and then I'll go through why is this rare in the emergency department. As you can see, I have a handheld portable ultrasound. This is called a V scan. I have video just about the V scan with a review of it. Anyway, the reason we're using the ultrasound in this case is to find the spot where most fluid or the biggest pocket of fluid that we can. This patient has ascites, which is fluid within the abdomen caused by non-alcoholic cirrhosis. Patient has some medications that might have induced some liver problems, and since then he's accumulated fluid in his belly enough to have it drained about once every 2 weeks. It happened that it was a weekend and he couldn't get to the outpatient center where they do this, so he couldn't breathe because his belly was so distended, pushing on his lungs, pushing on his abdomen. He couldn't eat because his stomach felt full. So anyway, the ultrasound finds the biggest spot of fluid, and then we clean iodine like we've described in other videos to make sure the area is nice and sterile. Now, this is a sterile procedure, so we want to kill all the bacteria. We're going to set up our sterile field. I'm wearing a hat, I'm wearing a mask, I'm wearing sterile gloves, I'm wearing a gown. The whole works, because it's got to be a clean procedure. Introducing bacteria into the abdomen can cause peritonitis and infection. And in a patient who has no problems right now, that would be really, really bad, because it was totally induced by us. So this is our sterile field. We're going to make it a little bigger by adding another sterile sheath. And this is a second kind of wipe, not iodine, but chlorhexidine. And it's another kind of skin disinfectant. This is my second sheet to add to the sterile field. Make sure nothing's touching non-sterile area. I was telling the patient there not to move his arm, because then when he moves his arm, he moves my sterile field, then he might get contaminated. Now this is the lidocaine. We're gonna numb him, and this is like any other numbing, just inject, pull back, make sure you're not having any blood, and pull back. But the trick to this injection is that you're gonna pull the skin to the side and enter the skin, because essentially what that does is the equivalent of entering the skin on an angle. And what that provides is, if you were to enter straight perpendicular and make a hole, then you can make a canal where this fluid can drain, even though we stopped draining the procedure. You took the needle out and it keeps draining because the canal's straight out. But by pulling the skin to the side and then releasing it when you're done, that skin moves, and now it creates an oblique and tamponade type canal, so it can't really come through that hole. So don't forget to do that when you do this kind of procedure. Here I'm injecting lidocaine, and you go in a little bit, inject some, go a little further, inject some again, until you get peritoneal fluid. And you can see that the clear lidocaine became a little yellowish, and that's because we got some acidic fluid in the syringe. So now I know I went all the way deep, and this is actually my paracentesis needle. It's essentially a big IV catheter. Is probably 3 to 4 inches long instead of 2 inches long for a regular IV catheter. And it's got a catheter, so once you go in and get to the space, you thread it in. The danger of any kind of procedure like this, you're entering with a needle into the abdominal cavity. You can hit bowel and create perforation, and bacteria come from the bowel to that fluid. Patient can get really sick. So that's why you want to make sure with the ultrasound that you have the biggest pocket available for you to do this procedure. The sides of the abdomen are the best one. As you can see here, I'm using a blade. That is because the needle I'm using is pretty thick. So trying to go in, I would have to apply a lot of force to go in through the skin. And applying that force, all of a sudden giving out, I could go really deep all of a sudden. So by nicking the skin, I'm making a little space for me not have to push as hard going into the skin. And you can see, as soon as I get fluid, I know I'm in that space. And what I do is, without entering the metal part anymore, I feed in the catheter part. And you can see, as soon as I pull out, there's fluid just dripping down. I mean, this fluid wants to find its way out. It wants to come out. So I have a big syringe that has 60 mLs, 20 ounces. And you can see nice, clear urine colored fluid. Most of the joint and acidic and fluids in the body are yellowish in nature, except for the lumbar puncture, which is the other video I did. That one's clear. But this is yellowish, it's very proteinaceous, means it has protein, so it's a little cloudy. So just the fact that it's cloudy doesn't mean there's any infection. And so I drain an initial 60, and those we get out because we want to send it to make sure there's no infection, cultures, gram stains, and so on. But this patient had no symptoms since he's had this many times, so we don't really have to send it for analysis. Other patients do because they're having symptoms of abdominal pain or fever and so on. So then we hook up that catheter to the tubing, and that tubing will allow us to connect it to suction bottles. Suction bottles are negative pressure glass bottles that once you enter in, they suction out. They have 1 liter bottles. They have bigger ones, some hospitals, but that's the one we had available. And you don't see what I'm doing here, but I'm actually hooking it up at the other end of that stick to the suction bottles. And I'll be showing you in just a minute how that looks. This is that suction bottle. You can see it's about a little bit more than half filled with this acidic fluid. This is our very first one. And I'm gonna show you a picture that shows that when we're about the third bottle into the procedure, actually fourth bottle into the procedure. So that's 4 liters so far. Each liter weighs about 2.5 pounds. So you're talking about 10 pounds of fluid removed from this patient already. That's a big deal. I fast forward a little bit so you can see the process being filled out and being changed. Yes, don't make fun of my shiny shoes. I like them a lot. There we go. So you can see the catheter, you know, it's going through, it's going into the bottle. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 bottles, 6 1-liter bottles, and then we use like 3 more smaller half-liter bottles. We just ran out of bottles in the emergency department, like I said. Not a very common procedure in the emergency department because we're too busy, it takes a lot of time, and usually we send them to interventional radiology where they do this, or they get admitted to a hospital and get this done. In this case, I really wanted to do the procedure because patient did not want to be admitted. He's had it many times, so it's not like it's a new thing for him or his family. They know how to take care of this. And finally, once I'm done, of course, remove the catheter, you know, put some pressure, and most importantly, put a Band-Aid to make sure that he heals well. Say a little prayer so God's with him and doesn't get any infection or any problems. And that's it. You could literally, while you were doing the procedure, you could literally see his belly being from so big and coming down, coming down, coming down. Total, we remove 7.5 liters, 25 pounds. I try to carry all the bottles in a box afterwards. It is heavy. So I'm instructing the patient, you know, to go and follow up with their GI doctor. I'm thanking them again for allowing me to record this video for the education of everybody, nurses, medical students, and people who need the procedure done. They can see how it's done, so their fear is less when they go to have it done. And that's it. We're done. Again, remember to clean your iodine. It can cause chemical burns. So we clean it and we're done. Go to ED Exit Video to see other videos and search